Tracked Kung Fu Maintenance. Got kind of a goofy one today, and an easy mistake to make with this timer. You actually have to have each of your days selected. You know, this tells me next start time, and I've already programmed it. But what we need to do is go select over to the how often setting. See, this button rotates through each particular option for setting. So you're going to go into the how often setting, and then for each zone, hit OK, and the water day, to make sure there's a box around the days that I want it to water. Okay, and once that's done, then you can hit your triangle button and set it to auto, and now you're going to run according to your timer. Okay, so now that I've got it on auto, it's scrolling through to show my next watering time is 1:01 p.m. It's right now about 12:58, and it'll actually show that on the screen, and then it shows my next zone time. So it's 12:58 right now, and I'll just verify that it turns on, and then it's going to scroll through. You can set it up for however you want it, every 6 hours, every 8 hours, every 24 hours, you know, and pick your days. So pretty cool, has a lot of customization to it. Just that one little tricky spot. All right, 12:59, I got 2 minutes for it to turn on. See how it goes. Some of my stuff dried out a little bit because I hadn't had the square around the timer. Sure, it's happened to other people, and want to make sure it doesn't happen to you, so I figured I'd communicate it here so you could see it, and so we can get it going. Okay, we're set to turn on at 1:01 on the third zone. It's now 1 o'clock, so it's time for the countdown. And it looks like that's zone 3. Whoa, that's going to turn on at 1:01. Got a backflow prevention deal right here. A backflow valve. Second now. Here's our zone 3. There it goes. Just kicked on. We're all set there. Thanks for watching. Kung Fu Maintenance. That's my zone 3. I think that goes up to my hill. Kind of forget which zone is which. Yep, that's the one. So my bougainvillea and stuff suffered a bit. I think because the water wasn't set to turn on, so that wasn't good. In the hottest time of the year too. Oh well, life goes on, right? It out. So hopefully I didn't lose anything, trees or anything. It's amazing the sunflower survived, did so well. Popped up, you hear the water turning on. There's this sprinkler on the hill that I did a video I showed you guys a while back. Yeah, and I'll have to readjust my program times, but just wanted to figure it out and map it out and make sure we got it in giant sunflower. All right. Just to run through this one more time, you need to select over to the how often setting. See, this button rotates through each particular option for setting. So you're going to go into the how often setting. And then for each zone,
Yeah, so for each zone, you'll set how long you want it to go, whether 8 hours, 6 hours, every 2 days, every 3 days, whatnot. But then you'll need to select each day to have a box around it that you want it to be on. A lot of other timers, you select it to, and the day disappears when it's off and it shows up when it's on. Not the case on this one. You need a box around it for it to be set for that day. That's the key, tricky part, and it's probably always a good idea to read the instructions before using the timer. It can spare you some headache. It could have spared me on this one. Some things are not as user intuitive. My advice to the designers and engineers is try to make things as user intuitive as possible. You know, make it work the way that people would normally think it should work. That can save a lot of headache and help people appreciate your products a lot more. But that's just my recommendation. Thanks for watching Kung Fu Maintenance. Over and out.